Okay, we are going to convert these two angles into degrees, minutes, and seconds. And let's look at the first one. We have 53.76 degrees, right? So in terms of the degrees, okay, the whole number here, it's a degrees, 53 degrees. So we can just write this down. We have the answer right here as 53 degrees. However, right here, whenever we have a decimal degrees, this is 0.76 degrees, right? We have to change that into minutes and seconds. And let's see how can we do that. Well, this right here is the decimal part. We can just say we are going to add, let me just write it as 0.76. This is still in degrees now, right? Well, we have to remember there are 60 minutes in 1 degree. So we will have to take this decimal part and multiply by 60. And when we do that, we can change this to minutes. And the prime right here stands for the minute, okay? And we just have to work this out. And let's just focus on this part. You just take your calculator, you multiply whatever the way that you want, right? So 0.76 times 60, you will get, this is plus 45.6 minutes, okay? And in terms of the minute, you know 45, it will be the minute, right? However, right here, the 0.6 minute, we have to change that into seconds. So similarly, we'll just write this as we add it with, for this part only, I'll put this down as 0.6, right? This is still in the minute. And to change that into seconds, we have to know that there are 60 seconds in 1 minute. So we'll take this, multiply by 60, and then we will be able to get to the seconds. And once again, this is the minute notation, and this is the second notation. And this right here, just multiply it, you will get 36 seconds. So all in all, as you can see, we will have the answer 53 degrees, and we have this additional 45 minutes. So I'll put this down in red, 45 minutes. And the last one is 36 seconds. And this is pretty much it. And everything ends out to be whole numbers, so that's great. Well, let's see another example right here real quick. 122.6853 degrees. This right here, it's a degrees already, right? So let's just go ahead and say this is 122 degrees. And we do the same thing as what we did earlier. This part, the decimal part for the degrees, we will have to take this and say this is 0.6853. And if we multiply this by 60, we will be able to change this into minutes. And just do this on your calculator also, you will get 41.118 minutes, all right? And now, the 41, the whole number part right here, is the minutes. Right here for the decimal part, we have to take this and change that into seconds. So to do that, we'll say, we just add it with, this is 0.118, and we multiply by 60, just like that. 60 seconds in 1 minute, right? If you don't remember this, just look at the clock or just think about the times, then that's pretty much all. Anyways, you multiply this out, you will end up with 7.08 seconds, okay? And usually when we're doing this kind of things, we want to just round it to the whole numbers, especially when you are talking about degrees, minutes, and seconds. Once you multiply this out, if you still end up with decimal, well, just kind of ignore the decimal part and round it down, right? Because this is just 7.08. All in all, we will have the answer for this one is 122 degrees, and then this is the 41 minutes. And the last part right here, it's the 7 seconds. And we are done. That's it.